So iOS 17.3 has been out for about a week now, and we're going to be talking about how awful it is in this video, because it's, like, really bad. Really bad. Anyways, let's waste no extra time, get straight into it. I don't really want to talk about this for too long, because I'm not going to lie, this is devastating. Like, it really makes me sad to see how bad iOS 17 just got with this update. But in my experience, it's been the worst iOS update in a very long time. And I no longer want to say that this update is the least buggiest since iOS 12, because I can't say that anymore. So for example, I have noticed slower app launching times. It is there. I don't know what happened internally, but my 15 Pro now hangs occasionally. There have been times where I literally cannot open the Apple Music app or even settings for like a minute. It just takes so long, I don't understand. Performance has been worse. It's just sad, but it's true. So stay on 17.2 if you care about performance. In terms of like everything else, aka animations and RAM management, it's the same. I mean, I haven't noticed any change. But yeah, it's just not good. Overall, that entire section pretty much gets an F in terms of, you know, just the difference between the earlier versions and this. It's just not good. And then, you know, moving on to battery, it's a very similar situation, an even worse situation here. It actually, you know, this keeps me up at night now. You know, I mean, I cried myself to sleep last night because the battery life is so much worse on this now. Like, I literally hardly used my phone in the past 24 hours, and by hardly, I mean 6 hours and 35 minutes of screen on time and about 2 hours idle. But 3 hours of that was just on the home and lock screen. I don't know. It just was. I just like to stare at my home screen a lot because it's beautiful. You know, it's iOS. So I stared at it for about 3 hours and 10 minutes, which was like half the time of that in total. Well, at least the screen active time. The music, I use Apple Music for like 2 hours in the background. And then I got like an hour and 30 minutes on YouTube. So this is where it gets bad, because before 17.3, this wouldn't be an issue, but I had to actually charge my phone because the battery life was just being sucked away. I could have probably worded that a little bit better, but you guys get the point. And then I had to charge it in the middle of the day. What is this? 9 a.m. I had to charge this phone at 9 in the morning. Actually, I don't even know what I'm looking at here, because this is standby drain. Oh my God. Literally do not know. I don't know. I don't know. The standby drain is awful. This is not normal. And then let's see. It's just not good. It has not been good. Like, this is unacceptable. The fact that I had to charge this thing at not even 12 a.m. This isn't normal. And it wasn't normal before, but it's normal now. So, and I know I'm not the only one experiencing battery drain on 17.3. Maybe I have to make a dedicated video about this. Let me know in the comments if you guys want to see a dedicated video regarding this, because I'll do it. But yeah, battery has been awful. Just terrible. The standby drain is like really bad. And I have to charge down in the middle of the day. And this is a 15 Pro. It's not even like a 11. So the fact that this is happening is kind of sad. And then as of overheating, to make things worse, my phone has been overheating. I didn't even experience, when I used 17.0 on this, I didn't experience those issues. Same thing with the versions up until 17.0.3. I did not experience this phone get hot, even remotely at all, one time. And yet now I'm on 17.3 and all of a sudden this is happening again. So it's just really upsetting to see. This is just not a very good update. And for the features you're getting, it's not worth the trade-off. I'm just going to flat out say don't update. If you're on anything but 17.3 right now, do not update. Wait for possibly 17.3.1. But 17.4 so far has been really fantastic on my 14 Pro Max. So I'd absolutely recommend, you know, waiting for that. And on my 15 Pro, I actually did update just now to iOS 17.4 Beta 1. And so far, it's been actually better. And just, you know, the not even a full day that I've been using it. Maybe it's been a day. No, it hasn't been a day yet. Much better. So I would stay there for now. Personally, I'm not going back, at least. Which means beta videos are coming soon. So for the 99% of you that aren't subscribed, I do those because other YouTubers don't. I go through iOS betas in depth and get every single solitary new change in feature, and then I release a video about it. So make sure to subscribe down below with notifications enabled, because those are back. But yeah, so battery life's been awful, overheating, performance has been worse. So, in terms of bugs, because this is where things get even worse, nothing has been fixed so far, so the notification bug is still there. The control center flashing is still there. Yes, the control center literally flashes me, and it's ridiculous. It's annoying. iPadOS doesn't even do this, and yet I'm getting too worked up over this right now. But the fact that this is still an issue is kind of insane. It's like, and sure, it's not the biggest deal in the world. Like, it doesn't break. It's not broken. As a lifetime iOS user, this is really upsetting to see. And something needs to change. Something needs to be done. This isn't normal. No matter what anyone says, this isn't normal. I don't know what's going on internally at Apple, but I really am starting to get very frustrated with these issues that make the quality of life of iOS so awful. So in conclusion, don't update 17.3 if you're not already there. Anyways, that is all I have for this video. It's more of a rant instead of a even remote review. I'm so fed up with all of these issues that I don't know anymore. All right, bye.